Switch by NDT, or actually Switch by NDT Dancers, is the creative platform created by and for the dancers of Nederlands Dance Theater. And kind of the main component of this creative platform is our annual charity event, in which the dancers of NDT create new choreographies. And not only that, also the entire event is basically from A to Z, created and organized and developed by the dancers themselves too. Last year was my first time. I've been part of NDT for 4 years now. This is my fifth year. My very first season, I was too intimidated and I wanted to see the project first. And I'd always been interested in choreographing. So my second and third year in the company, I actually choreographed. And my fourth year, I suddenly had this interest in being more than a dancer or a choreographer, something I'm already, the world is known to me. And I really wanted to challenge myself and see the other side of a production. So I decided to be part of the production team.
You know, as dancers, you're often having to interpret other people's artistic voices. And so it's an opportunity for us to explore our own voices.
In general, it creates opportunity, whether you're trying to figure out if you want to choreograph, if that's something you're interested in doing for the near future or the far future even. It gives us opportunity in ways of working with colleagues, and not only working with our colleagues in pieces by choreographers that come here, guest choreographers, house choreographers, associates. It's also really a fun time to really connect with one another for a different topic, for a different reason, for different intentions.
We never start out with that pressure because it's always fun, and it's like with your colleagues and your friends, and you're doing what you want to do. But somehow always, not in a bad way, but you feel excited about putting your own stuff out there, getting to explore your own ideas. And so you kind of end up feeling that pressure of it.
Yeah, I believe the biggest pressure that comes to us is the pressure we create ourselves as choreographers, especially if it's one of the first times you do it. It's one of the first times you're putting a piece together. It's one of the first times you're trying to say something in another way than dancing yourself. So this time you're creating something for somebody else, or maybe even for yourself, but you're expressing yourself differently. So I think that also gives us this feel that we have to do well, or we want to do well, not necessarily have to, but we want to. So I think we pressure the dancers pressure themselves by nature, I think, whether we want to or not. And especially when it comes to new grounds, I feel like the pressure just shows up.
Yeah, and like it's quite a rare opportunity for dancers to have all these resources available to them to create what they want. It's just so often that you have to like scramble together everything to make it work, and here everything's ready for you to use. And so like that opportunity also puts pressure on, like you have to make the most of that. You have to honor that, you have to appreciate that. Because it's not something that anyone gets to do.
Every year it's a different amount of people being part of the production team. Last year, for example, it was just 4 people. This year it's 11, so it really does keep changing. On average, we have about, I'd say, 10 to 20 choreographers.
Every year, it's kind of like you carve away a little bit more, you learn a little bit more about your own artistic voice and values. And then the more you learn about that, the more you can see other people's values. So when you're working with someone in the studio, it's a lot more transparent where they're coming from and what they're trying to say. So it's nice to be able to feel that and go with them in that direction. And then also to be able to know if you disagree with something. Because the more you have an idea of your own values, the more you can have an idea of how you interact with other people's. If you want to be a choreographer, it means you think you have something worth saying. And I think everyone has something worth saying, but it implies that you think there's a certain amount of ego involved that is inseparable from, like, also a movie director, like someone who believes that their vision is worth putting out there for people to see. And so, like, I also struggle a bit with the amount of ego needed to pursue the goal of being a choreographer. With that said, I also really love choreographing, and it's something I want to do. But it's hard to come to terms with the kind of person you sometimes have to be to pursue that.
They know we're not going to come out that evening doing something just because we have the privilege to do something. The dancers that do sign up is because we want to, and we have something to say, we have something to put out there. And even that evening of setting out the tatami and cooking noodles and talking for, I don't know, whatever, 12-15 minutes, it wasn't they didn't, at least I believe, and also from what I remember talking to them, it wasn't to do just to give somebody a slap in the face and be like, we can do whatever we want to, so we're gonna do this, even though it's a dance performance. It's a performance, whether it's with movement, whether it's with singing, whether it's with cooking, for that matter.
So there's definitely other companies that encourage their dancers to create choreographies, and they usually call it young choreographers, or I'm not quite sure what the names are, but it's usually still run by the company itself. It's still in the program of the company. And another big element of it is that they usually make a selection of which choreographies eventually, you know, get a place on the stage. So that's something that's not exactly the same. It's usually also not entirely run by the dancers. And the charity aspect, I think, is something very unique we have. What's so beautiful about Switch is that any dancer can create something, and you literally can do anything you want. There will never be someone who says, I'm sorry, you're not allowed to do that, or it doesn't fit within the vision of Switch, because the vision of Switch is limitless. That's what we stand for. We stand for finding your own voice, discovering what your creative agency is, how can you be innovative, how can you make an impact, what do you have to say. So to put somehow a guideline on that, or to not allow certain things, that goes, I guess that kind of goes against what we stand for, is actually very unique in the arts world, because we are an industry that actually really needs money. You know, every year we hear about budgets being cut and how it's hard for dancers to actually make a career out of dance. So of course it's a very unique quality that we have a whole evening of dance and we actually don't keep any of the revenue. The amazing thing about Switch is that it was started with a group of dancers who just wanted to create, and it was for their colleagues, and over the years it has grown into this annual charity event where we raise on average 35,000 euros for the charity, and every year it's actually expanding. So last year for the first time, we worked together with graphic design students from the Royal Art Academy here in The Hague. And this year we've actually established a collaboration with the school. So every year they take it on as a practical assignment for their students, for their graphic design students. So again, for that, it's a step further. It's a step branching out, working with other departments, other artists. You know, now they have a chance to give Switch a new event style every year. And this way, it's not just our influence of creativity, but we also have influences from the outside. And it's another way for us to share. And also, we're launching a website this year. And in order, with this website, we want to branch out. We want to share with the dance community, not just within The Hague, but within the whole world, and make it clear that it's a creative platform and not just this one event. Another aspect we've added is, for example, the social media account. We invite dancers from all over the world to send in their improv videos. And this way, again, we are expanding our little community of Switch to something way more than it was originally started as.
Having Switch be about the charities that we're donating to keeps the event grounded. So it keeps the event from being about us in a way. I mean, it's still us performing and it's our pieces, but it makes it about something broader. And I think that's what it brings more to the performance. It will inspire more people to come, and it will inspire more people to participate in the event, to donate their time and resources to it in making it happen. And I think, like, we're also exploring our own creative ideas, but to do it in the name of a charitable cause, I think inspires us to do it to the fullest.
So the production team, we get together, I'd say, like 4 months ahead of the actual event, and we discuss what the interests are at the moment. So this year we had three topics. It was human rights, animal rights, and environmental issues. So within those three categories, we kind of split the team, and everybody found the best charities they could find. And then we also actually, people from NDT helped us look at how legit all of these charities are. And then through that, we picked three final ones. So one was within animal rights, one was within human rights, and one within environment. And in the end, the whole company actually can vote on those three. So in the end, all of the dancers of NDT choose which charity we support.
What also inspires us in the fact that we choose these charities, not just to get to the point, okay, this is an event where we are given the opportunity to do something for us, but eventually also for really using that event and using that opportunity to connect these factors. To really also, we could go deeper and say these things, and is art gonna make the world better? Is art gonna help the world in any form? But if we start with a charity like this, and we focus on the charity that we actually chose, I believe we slowly make the tiniest difference. And that's where I think it would be silly if, we create a piece in the name of a charity focusing on the plastic use and recycling and all that stuff, and then I create a piece for 16 dancers with 16 fold-up plastic chairs.
Well, last year we worked with LGBT asylum support, and we actually came together with these asylum seekers, and we danced and we taught them a workshop and we shared. They came to see the show, they saw backstage. We actually have a very small kind of startup budget to initiate the things we need to do. So for example, we need to arrange anything really, from drinks at the bar to having a fridge to cool the drinks, having a floor for the evening, arranging everything with the technical department, making sure that the dancers understand what our time schedule is, communicating with people from outside, let's say a printer for the flyers, how do we make a poster, do we collaborate with students, do we make this ourselves, how do we have music for in the evening, but we want that donated because it's a whole charity event and we cannot pay people. So it's always very much a constantly trying to find solutions to these little, not problems, but to these little obstacles you run into. We all get to learn, new aspects of the job of setting up an entire event. But it's also challenging because we don't know. I have never been to business school. I have no education in how to do budgeting for such a huge event. There are so many elements that we actually know nothing about. So in a way, you kind of jump into the deep end, and that's how you just like jump in, and that's how you learn how to swim. To me, it's the most amazing way to learn, because you just learn along the way.
I find it hard to say I want to become a choreographer. Of course, I want to dive into it. I want to work around it. I want to work with it. But I think you're set for, not you're set for disappointment, but to go one direction and really trying to only focus in one destination without necessarily allowing for it to maybe not only go straight towards there, but to go around, go up and down, go right and left to reach that kind of point. I think it's also healthier. I found it to be more healthy for myself to not be so obsessive and this is what I want to do and this is what I want to reach. This is where I'm going to go.
I believe that what Switch is trying to say is new and very innovative. Of course, we are dancers within a structured company, but what we are doing is actually not within the guidelines of a structured company. We expand, we share, we collaborate. There's no rules, there's no limits or guidelines. We can really do whatever we want. We're also showing choreographies and voices by usually a lot younger artists, which to me is a choreography is kind of a reflection of society, what's going on now. And I believe it's this new movement of really wanting to make an impact and not making choreography for the sake of the performance, for the sake of being able to say something that means a lot to yourself, but also being able to say something because you know it will make an impact. I believe that through dance you can actually, instead of just words or a piece of text, it can very much pierce the soul. And as soon as you connect with someone in that way, you can actually make people view big topics in this very, they can see the world through different eyes because they suddenly understand things they didn't understand before. So I've seen performances where I can suddenly feel an emotion or understand something and I've never even experienced this. And I believe that this is the power of dance and art in general, is we can actually I don't believe we can directly save the world, but indirectly we can. Because if we make people conscious, if we awaken them through, let's say, touching their soul or piercing or somehow giving them a bit of a slap in the face, maybe that can then eventually make them take actions that can, let's say, save the world.
I don't think we can say we need a couple more of those and then we're going to be at a point where we make a difference. No, we need as many as we can get. We need as many as we can afford. We can program, we can produce as many. I don't think there should be a limit to this desire to make a change with these kind of collaborations. Yeah, I think it comes down to also dancers are so hungry. And I could not imagine, and I've never heard any dancer or performer say that they don't want to make a difference with what they're doing. So I think in that sense, as not selfish is the wrong word, but as self-focused we sometimes are into our career, I think at the same time we're also really wanting to guide everything further, take everything into whatever direction, whether it's right, left, or forward, sometimes even backwards. But I think we do.
I do believe that dancers can be so much more. You know, I see it with my colleagues. They are all such beautiful individuals, and the work they make when they have the opportunity to make something is incredible. So I keep wondering, like, whoa, these are just the dancers within NDT, but all of the dancers across the world who are in companies, what do they have to offer? And I hope that one day through Switch, or maybe connecting their projects to Switch, we can open up the possibility for other dancers too.